Hi guys, and welcome to another WordPress video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignertechtips.com. We've been looking at this page builder, Elementor, and we quickly put together this one page site yesterday. Let's go through it in a bit more detail. This one, let's start with examining our sections. So I'm going to create a new page. And I'm just going to call it T2 for test 2. Again, I'm going to use the same template as we did before, which was the Elementor full width. And now let's edit our edit with the Elementor page build. There we go, we've got a full width page to play with now. So this time we're just going to add some sections of our own. Last time we hit the archive button here and added one of these pre-built layouts. They've got whole page layouts and they've got just some individual block layouts. And there's pro versions which you need the pro theme for or the pro builder for. Well, there's plenty of free ones to be going on with. But we're going to do it from scratch today. So let's add this. Let's click this little red plus icon here and add a section. When you click it, it's going to ask us what, how many columns we want, 1, 2, etc., etc. Let's just go for a 2-column right now. There we are, there's our section, and it's put in these 2 columns for us here. If we decided we wanted more at a later date, you can click on this little black button here, and you can duplicate it. So now we've got 3 columns. And of course, you can click on it again to delete it if you don't want it. So we'll stick to 2 columns. Let's just stick something in there, because we want to work on this section today. And this big tag, blue tag at the top, is for the section. Got the plus button to add another section. You've got the middle buttons to edit the section. And you've got an X on the right hand side to get rid of the section. So I'm just going to put in a bit of text here. And I just dragged, if we go back there, hit the grid. Up here, it'll take you back to your widgets. I just grabbed the text editor one here and I dragged it over to where we wanted to put it. And to edit it, either just click on it or click on the pen icon, and here it is. And I'll just put in test section. And I'll make that a heading. That's fine. And I'll update that. And for the time being, I'm not going to put anything in this section because I really wanted to, or this little block here. So I really want to work with our sections here. So I'm going to hit the edit section button right here. And let's see what we've got. Okay. Have a look at our two little columns that we've got in there. They're stretching out to here. You can see the end of them here. You can actually make this full width. And now they've stretched the whole, the available space there. I'll keep those boxed. Or looks like you can specify a width. You can make them bigger or smaller. I think 1140 is standard. That lets you make them bigger or smaller. Now the gap between the columns here, between this one and this one, but let's just clone this column. Copy. And can we paste it in here? Or click on the little box there and paste. There we go, and let's get rid of that one we didn't want. Now, we can set, if we go back to our section, we can set the columns gap. So we've got the default, which is what we've got now. We can have no gap. They touch each other, that's great for images and stuff like that. We can have narrow. Okay, extended wide, wider. Let's see what the widest is. Okay, that's pretty good. So let's put that back on default. Content position. I see that's going to align our actual content in the middle or at the top or the bottom. That's quite handy too. And this is if we want to give it an HTML tag other than the original. I imagine their default's probably div. Okay, that's fine. And structures, as you can see, we've added and made those bigger and smaller. I see, so you've got a third on the left and two thirds on the right, plus this way. Pretty sure you can actually grab that and do it manually as well. Resize these things manually if you need to. Let's put that back to how it was. All right, now how easy is it to color the background or something like that? We did this yesterday. Okay, here's our background we've got highlighted there. We can add a color. There we go, we've given it a blue background. That was pretty easy. Now we want to make these bigger. How do we actually make these bigger, I wonder? I'm just going to copy this over a few times. There we go, that makes our section a lot deeper there. Okay, so we've tried a color. Gradient, as we know, that was easy enough to do. Just select your top color here. And when you're happy, select your bottom color here. Easy enough to do. Now what about, I'll bring that text out, so that must be style. Here we are, text color, make that white. It's easy enough. What about our headings? Ah, and we got spacing up here, that's great. Must be a way of changing those headings, heading colors also. Here we can change the font family, obviously. Letter spacing, line style, etc. Must be able to change the heading. Surely. Let's give it some padding, top and bottom. Get 50 pixels. It's giving it 50 pixels all sides. You can uncheck the little thing there if you want different values. But I don't, so let's put that back to 50. Now, I wonder how we can change that. I'm sure it should be very easy to do. I guess we change it manually. Another color there. Okay, it's not quite what I wanted to do, but it'll do. So at least we've got a bit of height to our section there. And have they got, yes, they've got padding in our advanced section here. Let's uncheck that and just give it some padding top and bottom of 100, I think. There we go. We've got a nice big section going on there. And we can give it a CSS ID if we want to. We covered that last time. If you want to jump to this section, just give it a CSS ID. And let's put a video behind there. How easy is that? So I'm going to go to YouTube here. I've just got a Shanghai video. I've hit the share button. Here's a URL of the video. So I'm going to copy that. And let's paste this in here. Okay, there's a video behind it. Quite often there's an entry title in the videos. You can have it start later on. Let's say have it start at 45 second mark. And let's run it for 170 seconds. Well, that was easy enough to do. And a fallback image on quite a lot of smaller devices, it won't play the video in the background. So if you just do a screen capture of your video and then upload it as an image, you've got a fallback image. When the video doesn't play, it'll just play the full, it'll just show the fallback image. That's great. Image is working good. What do we need to do to make this more visible? We can put a background overlay around it. It can be a gradient or a color. Let's just use a color. Well, let's put blue because it's there. That's pretty good. Now we can make it a darker blue. And we can bring the opacity down, or opacity, if we decide we want to see more of the background video there. Of course, now I'm on the nighttime version, it's the writing standing out more, but I'll put that blue back up how it was. That's pretty impressive. Very good. So there's just few of the elements we got in the section. It's got some nice little things to edit it with. A border. Choose what you want. Shape divider. It's interesting. We put it on the bottom. Let's see what we've got. Types, we've got what about clouds? There we go. And I guess we could put one on the top as well. Put the same one on the top. There you go. Now you've got a little cloud bubble section with your video behind it. That's actually quite cool. And you can make them higher or lower. And flip them. I don't think I want to do that. That's kind of interesting. You've got the same on top and bottom but reversed. And you bring them to front, which means they'll be in front of your content there. That's pretty cool. Typography. Okay, you can set the heading color for each individual section here. That's quite good too. And the text alignment. So let's just update and preview, and we'll leave that video here today. There you have it. There's our video section with our overlays and borders. and dividers. Very easy to do. So very good. In our next video, we'll explore some more of the widgets and just start putting a little site together manually. I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web development, take a look down below. We've got some great free classes. There's also some premium classes down there with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.